Tonight, from Lucas Oil Stadium in Indianapolis, it's a special primetime edition of the NFL on EA Sports. It's the Indianapolis Colts taking on the Houston Texans.
We are pleased, as always, to be bringing you coverage of the National Football League on EA Sports. But tonight, we've got a good AFC matchup on tap, as it'll be the Houston Texans taking on the Indianapolis Colts. With Charles Davis, as always, I'm Brandon Gauden. Now, Charles, you and I, we've done a lot of games together. Always seems like we're rehashing the same storylines. Turnovers, of course, always a big story. Quarterback play, running backs, yada, yada, yada. But getting ready for this one word kept coming to mind, and that's preparation.
Well, it's critical to be prepared physically, mentally. When you think about getting ready for an NFL game, you have to wonder, what will they throw at us that maybe we haven't seen before? Two-minute drill, maybe different things like that. Got to be prepared. You're exactly right.
So here's Kyemi Fairbairn to do the honors. And we are underway here on EA Sports. Taking it about the one. And able to take it past the 25 and up to the 28-yard line. So the Colts now coming out for their opening drive. Leading them out, still one of the most recognizable QBs in the game and one of the most fun QBs in his fifth season, it's Gardner Minshew.
And how about this young man? Took the NFL world by storm as a six-round rookie, signature mullet, mustache, but 21 touchdowns for the Jacksonville Jaguars. Great personality, and everyone gravitates towards this guy. Teammates love to win with a quarterback who leads them like that, and fans love to root for a guy who seems just like them.
Minshew going to look to throw it right away. Look at the big man rumble. And he's all the way up to the 39-yard line that time. That's a pickup of 11 and a first down on their first offensive play.
Love this look to start the ball game. They empty the backfield right away. And that's going to put some early stress on both their offensive line and on the secondary. And here they get the completion and a quick first down.
Here's the former NFL rushing champ. It's Jonathan Taylor. And able to get this one all the way up to about the 46-yard line. A solid run on first down. Gain of 7 leaves him with a 2nd and 3.
But that run right there was an offensive line coach's dream, wasn't it? Guys picked up all of their assignments, created a nice gap for the running back to get through. Pick up 7 yards. Yeah, he's probably chortling on the headset right now saying, "We got it going, boys. Let's keep it going."
Under pressure, and the Texans able to get in there for the sack. Malik Collins busting through to get him for a loss of 6. He seemed to have a reasonable amount of time in the pocket, but he couldn't get rid of the football, and the end result, Charles, him on the ground.
Yeah, he's got to keep an internal clock to go along with his offensive line. When you're talking about 3, 4, 5 seconds, that's a reasonable amount of time to expect to deliver the ball downfield. So great to try and complete a pass, but it's equally important to know when to throw the football away, too.
They'll come to the line here needing 9 yards to pick up the first. Now Minshew. He's going to launch this thing way downfield. Oh, and that is incomplete.
You get a sense of what this game plan might be. They think they can take a few home run shots against this defense. They tried it there on the opening drive, but that ball's incomplete.
On fourth down, the Colts will call on Rigoberto Sanchez for the punt. Desmond King deep for Houston. And not what he was hoping for there, as this will hit in the end zone for a touchback. So out come the Texans for their opening drive. Leading them out, a two-year starter at Ohio State and second overall pick in the draft, C.J. Stroud.
I tell you what, when he is on schedule for that week, secondaries take notice because you've got to stay alert back there on every snap. A truly powerful arm, one that's capable of challenging any level of the defense on any given play. That's why so many scouts preach arm talent when preparing for the NFL draft. A quarterback with arm strength to make every throw in the book, he's an asset to have in any offense.
On the ground, it's Pierce to begin the drive. And he'll go down at the 26, following a gain of 6.
A quick burst there, and he nicely bit off a pretty decent gain.
From the 26, they'll line up on 2nd and 4. Now the first carry for Devin Singletary. And tackled down after a gain of 3. Leaves him with 1 yard to go on 3rd down. And that's some good tackling there to keep him short of that yellow line.
Yeah, and defensively, all I'm thinking is that on that play, get me to 3rd down. Get me into a position where I can make one more play and get my defense off the field.
Here now, 3rd and 1 yard. Stroud able to find the open man. That's complete. And he is going to have a Texans first down as they're able to get the 3rd down conversion. Got to say, I was a little surprised to see him, Charles, come out in the shotgun on 3rd and less than 1 yard.
Yeah, but the way the NFL is nowadays, we hardly ever see anyone really run for it on short yardage. So they're going to throw the football more times than not. That was a nice, easy rhythm throw right there. And they pick up the 1st down.
Stroud to the air on 1st and 10. Another one caught by Collins. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. 13 yards as they've got the connection working. His 2nd catch in a row, 1st down.
That was a nicely run slant route, and what the receiver's trying to do is make the defender think he's going upfield for a deeper route, and then breaks it off, usually after about 3 to 4 steps, and cuts towards the middle of the field. And now what he's trying to do is use his body to keep the defender away from the football and give the quarterback a really nice target.
Well, they've been back on their heels a little bit here in this drive, but a chance to exhale just a little bit there with incompletion on 1st down. Now they have to gear up, try and get 2 more stops and escape this drive.
Now a 2nd and 10. Stroud will look to throw once more. Pass complete. He's got Woods streaking across the field. And they'll get him to the ground. He has another 1st down at the Colts 35. Texans passing game in rhythm right now, picking up another 1st. Give the rookie another one on this opening drive and a 1st down with it. A nice start, Charles, for the first-year passer. He's come out, made a few plays, nice plays to begin this contest.
He certainly has, and if he finishes off this drive with a touchdown pass, I vote we don't call him rookie anymore. We'll move him right to veteran and continue from there.
And this will leave him 1 yard short. Nice pickup of 9 yards on 1st down. We've seen quite a bit of the short passing game here early on 1st quarter, haven't we?
We have, and I think it works a couple of ways for this team because, number one, you throw the short game until they stop it. And if they're not going to stop it, you keep throwing it, and occasionally you'll break a tackle and turn into a bigger gain. Also, if they start to creep up, start to pressure receivers, now you go over the top, take it deep, and now you get some of those big shots downfield.
No score after 1 on EA Sports. Texans football to start quarter 2 as they've got it with a 1st and 10. Singletary again, and he's going to lose yards. They take him down at the 26. He'll lose a yard there, and it's second and 11.
That was well played there defensively. Two tight ends in the formation, which essentially gave them seven blockers up front. Hard to imagine with all that size and beef that they could let a tackler through, but that's exactly what happened. A loss resulted.
Maybe just a slight detour on what's been a strong drive here, second and 11. Stroud to throw it. Steps away to his left. And they'll work it inside the 15-yard line before it's all said and done. Opted to run for it. The decision a good one, picking up the first, getting 14 yards on the scramble.
As we both know, there's a lot that went into why they made him their first-round pick this year, and part of it was what they saw in college, his playmaking ability when things break down. As soon as he saw he wasn't getting a lane to throw, he pivoted and found an alternate way to the marker.
From the 13 now, they work on first and 10. Pierce now up the middle. And he'll take this one in for a Texans touchdown. Damian Pierce. A 13-yard touchdown run. And the Texans post the first points of the ball game as they take the lead here in this second quarter. And on his way to the end zone, shedding the tackle, he would not be denied.
That's what's called finishing the run, making sure you power your way through. One-on-one tackle, no running back wants to go to the bench and say, I got stopped just short.
Kaimi Fairbairn on for the extra point. And the Texans take a 7-0 lead. So that one a long 11-play drive. And it was Damian Pierce closing things out with a touchdown run. So after the touchdown, here's Fairbairn now to kick it away. And he'll go down as this drive will start at the 25-yard line. Second drive coming up here for the Indianapolis Colts. They'll be looking to match that touchdown from a moment ago. 7-0 is the score as they begin with a first down. Minshew sets to throw. Flushed out right. And this turns into a nice gain with a slide at the end. Nothing open downfield. He keeps it himself for 11 and a first down.
Certainly not the way they drew it up in the playbook, but that's why they love this guy back there. He sees things breaking down, and he's more than capable of finding an escape route and still getting a decent gain.
So from the 36 now, first and 10. Looking to throw it, Minshew. And I think the ball's out, but this will fortunately wind up out of bounds. A nice job there on the escape and scramble, a first down, a 16-yard gain. Can almost see inside his face mask there the look of relief. He coughed it up, but it goes out of bounds. They keep it.
Someone carrying around the lucky horseshoe, aren't they? If I were him, I'd go out and play the lottery after that one. A very fortunate man.
And they're operating in plus territory here. They're thinking points. Definitely don't want to lose the football at this juncture. Hey, So a first and 10 now in Houston territory at the 47. Here's Minshew. He'll let one go deep for Downs. And he knocks the ball away and it falls incomplete.
Zone coverage there and they were playing deep. That makes it obviously a little bit harder to run by guys. And that time, there was not much of a window to get the ball in there, and it winds up incomplete.
After the incomplete pass here now is second and 10. Off play action, it's Minshew. Now a quick throw there, but it's going to be incomplete.
You could tell they wanted to get that ball downfield, but they had nothing working in the secondary, so he dropped it off to the running back. That one ended up incomplete.
So back-to-back incompletions, and that has him staring at a third and 10. They'll set up to throw. Hits his target, the tight end, Mo Alie-Cox. And he's going to be taken down with another first down as the stop's made at the Texans 36. A nice pickup there of 11 yards, and it'll move the sticks.
Good job there of getting his tight end involved because he lines up on the right side of the formation, just works his way across the field. I really like how they were in sync on that one. He spotted the open gap in the zone, and his quarterback found him, and they get a first down.
Minshew, first and 10. This will be taken in by Michael Pittman. And he works it past the 30, almost to the 25. They get 10 more there, and I believe that'll be enough for another first down. It will. Two minutes on the clock, second quarter, 7-0 ball game. Minshew on first and 10. And that is going to be incomplete as he led him a bit too much.
So it looks like they still have some fight in them on this series because it seemed like things were headed for the red zone. But if this defense gets two more stops, they can keep them out of that area.
Once again, they'll come up on the 26-yard line, second and 10. Again, Minshew looking to throw. Connecting over the middle with Downs. And he takes it down to the 10-yard line. He's got his first catch here before halftime, and it goes for a first down.
And that's a more than acceptable read right there because it's zone coverage, so timing is everything. This time he waits for his man to come open, puts it right on him, and they pick up a first down.
A chance now to get even before the break as they come up first and goal. Back to throw again. A throw left sideline falls incomplete.
I'm really liking what I'm seeing from this defense because their coverage has been playing at a shutdown level so far. Even backed up late, they're forcing incompletions and fighting to keep them out of the end zone as the first half winds down.
They'll go again here from the 10-yard line on second and goal. Again, he'll drop to throw. To the end zone, but it's incomplete.
Oh, they were so close. That close to their first points of the game. Just needed to hang on just a second longer, but he couldn't complete the process of the catch through the jostling from the defender.
A big play forthcoming. Here's third and goal. From the gun, Minshew to throw. Over the middle, it's complete. Now the Texans will burn the first of their timeouts as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. Yeah. Matt Gay now gets ready for the field goal try. This a fairly straightforward 22-yard short attempt. And the holder's going to keep it. He's going to try to run for it. They pass up the three, fake it. It doesn't work. And this Texans defense comes up with a goal line stand. Well, that was an intriguing call. You got a chip shot field goal. Tight game. Why not just take the three?
I know that not all the old rules apply in today's NFL, and in fact, I'd love to have an analytics coach here with us right now to say why that was probably a good play. I don't know that even the analytics coach would have said that. That seemed like a bad play. Take the points there and move on.
Singletary to get the drive started. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. But a nice little gain. It's a 6-yard pickup, and it gets him to second and four. Now the Texans will use one of their two remaining timeouts as they'll stop it with just over a minute to go before halftime. This second and four. Here's Stroud. And this turns into disaster. He's not going to get forward progress. That'll be a safety.
Every team has plays in their book to try and buy some room when a safety's on the table. But a big variable is how does each team deal with the pressure of executing in those situations? In this case, they didn't, and they gave up 2 points.
After the safety, remember, they also need to give up the football, and here's the free kick. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. The Colts going to take over now late in this first half. And with them trailing, there is still enough time to try to string a few plays together, maybe get into field goal range. On first down is Minshew. That's complete to Pierce. And they're able to get this one across the 35. The Colts going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll stop it with just over 40 seconds to go in the first half. So here's a first and 10 at the 38. Out of the gun is Minshew. A short throw. This is caught by Cox. And he'll be out of bounds after getting this one across the 40. So 5 yards here, five on the play. And that'll make it second down.
And there's a completion to the tight end. And look at the size of these players nowadays. At that spot, 6'4", 6'5", and up. A lot of guys used to be basketball players, somehow came back to football. And that's really good for the game of football. You're getting better athleticism, great hand-eye coordination, guys who know how to control their bodies when they run their routes.
On second down, Minshew throwing quickly there, but it's incomplete.
But there's an incompletion, partner, and the struggles through the air continue because so far their lack of passing production has led to a lack of points.
They come up now third and five following the incomplete pass. It'll be Minshew again. They'll set up the screen to Taylor. And out of bounds on the other side of midfield at the 45. A gain of 11 that time, and a Colts first down.
When you run a screen pass really well, you gotta like the look of it because so many parts come together to make it work well. The offensive linemen where they're faking people out, the back slipping out there, catching the football, then all of them going together as one unit downfield, a really nice pickup.
This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. They'll stick with the passing game as he looks to throw.
Quick slant caught by Pierce.
Now the Colts going to burn the second of their timeouts as they'll stop the clock with 24 seconds to go in this first half. To throw again.
He'll drop this down to Taylor.
And he'll get this one down to about the 20-yard line. Now the Colts will use their third and final timeout. And with halftime on the horizon, they'll be out of timeouts from here forward. Matt Gay now gets ready for the field goal try. This will be a 37-yard attempt. Gay's kick is good, and that will cut the lead down to just two.
So add three, all told, after the safety, it's a five-point swing. That could have turned out much worse.
Well, you don't want to say no harm, no foul, but I do believe you're right. A nine-point swing hurts. 5 points, much more manageable, especially in a tight game like this.
So not much time to speak of remaining in this first half as the kick's away. Taken at the goal line. And he'll get it up past the 20 to about the 22. The Texans offense ready to go here for their next drive. And from this spot in the field with the clock where it's at, you think we're just going to see a knee and that's it?
And I think in this situation, that's the proper play. But we do know there's some risk takers out there that may want to take one more shot before the clock runs out.
So we have reached halftime here. It's the visitors, the Texans, out in front. As we'll send you down to Orlando, and we check in with Jonathan Coachman for our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach.
All right, Brandon, back to you two in just a bit. But first, welcome everyone to downtown Orlando and our EA Sports Halftime Report. This one has been a hard-hitting affair to this point, and you gotta expect we'll see more of the same in the second half. And to bring the action your way, let's get it right back out to Brandon Gott.
Okay, Coach, yeah, adjustments likely going to play a big role in this third quarter in what's been a tight contest so far. It's the Texans in front, and they're going to get the football first as we are back underway in the third quarter. This taken in right around the goal line. And the tackle going to be made right there at the 25-yard line. The Texans going to take over here to start quarter number three. Their defense has done the job. Now it's the offense's turn as they've got it first and 10. The third quarter starts with a run by Singletary. And he'll manage to pick up about four. It's second down.
Nice chunk of yards on first down. It really opens up your options for what you want to do on second. You go right back to him and hope he explodes, or sucker the defense in before throwing over the top.
Second and six, just inside the 30. They go right back to Singletary. And able to stay on his feet past the 30 to about the 33-yard line. Give him four on the carry, and it'll make this a third and about two.
He continues to struggle to find a crease to break off a big one and might need to just put that aside and just try and ram his way forward and get what he can.
Two yards still to go. Third down now. They'll try and run for this with Singletary. Well, they hit him in the backfield, and he will not escape. And that is not going to get it done. Tough sledding. They lose a yard there on third.
Well, we saw a lot of negative plays that resulted in plenty of lost yardage in the first half. And that trend is continuing here.
Here's Cameron Johnston now, as he's on to punt for the first time tonight. And that is much too long. That's into the end zone for a touchback. Here's the Colts now as they get ready for their first possession on offense of the second half.
Now this game, it has obviously been all about the defense on both sides of the football. Which offense is going to break through here? We'll see if they can do it on this drive. Hey, Minshew and the Colts going to come up here first and 10 at the 20. He'll start with a give to Taylor.
Fights forward for only about a yard up to the 21.
I have to think a major focus of the halftime meetings had to be figuring out how to create space for the running game to get operating.
Well, what you pointed out to me at half seems accurate. That line has struggled to sustain blocks.
Yeah, I would agree with that totally. They've got to focus on staying on their double teams at the first level, make sure that block's secured before they slide off and try and chip someone at the second level.
And Minshew with nowhere to go, and they take him to the ground. Sheldon Rankins abruptly ends that play with a sack.
We are seeing two really confident defenses imposing their will on these offenses in this game.
Yeah, absolutely, going toe for toe. Just curious if one of these offenses can wake up a little bit.
If there's any way they can find something that can pop, something big to knock them back on their heels.
Third and 12. Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. Work in the middle of the field, and he's got a man complete. And he'll be corralled well upfield right around the 40-yard line. Give him 22 there on the third down conversion.
You know I'm going to lean towards the defender, right? You know I'm going to do that.
I know.
That's a tough situation for him as I see it. But the truth of the matter is, that ball was not streaking towards him. Had a little arc on it. He's got to find a way to get his head around and make a play on the football.
First and 10, Taylor now. Taken down at the 42.
I'd say they've got to find a way to get him going. He's such a big part of their offense. I wonder if they might throw it a little and come back to the run.
Anything, because you're right. He's pretty much been completely neutralized. Here's a second and eight. They're going to look to throw. And he'll get it out to midfield. Let's say, yeah, they'll spot it right at midfield at the 50. Good work by Minshew there to pick up the first.
Well, this has certainly turned into a showcase game for what he can do on the ground, because they're just continuing to give him chances to run it, and he's earning every additional carry by putting up positive yardage on each run.
Running straight ahead, Taylor. And he can only manage to get a couple. Second and 8 coming up.
Well, they're hoping that the second half is better for him than the first half. They've got to find a way to get him going. He's a big part of their offense.
From a couple of yards beyond midfield, here's second and 8. They run once more with Taylor. And good space to operate there as he takes this down inside the 35-yard line. Three quarters in the books. We'll return with more after this break. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Back now in Indianapolis. It's been a good one so far. Just a 2-point game here as we get set for quarter number 4. From the 34 now, here's first and 10. Up the middle, here's Taylor. And able to get this to the 31.
Well, any lane that might have been open there was closed pretty quickly, and that was because the defensive front, they won that battle at the point of attack at the line of scrimmage. They used great leverage, held their spot, and stacked him up.
This a second and 8. Now they'll switch it up here and look to throw. And they will not get the connection there. It's incomplete.
Yeah, offenses always try to be smart about when they're trying to dial up a screen to the running back, because they understand you can only go to the well so many times in a game without the defense starting to anticipate the call.
And if you're thinking field goal from here, it's 48 yards. I think they'd like to get him a little help now on third down and move it closer. Flush to his right. He's got his target. That's complete. And he'll be brought down with a penalty flag on the field. It was a late decision to throw, and it might have been too late. So the big play nullified, a legal forward pass.
And maybe we know why they were able to get such a good chunk of yardage on that play. That pass was illegal.
So here we go. Maybe the biggest kick of the game forthcoming. This for a fourth quarter lead. And Gay knocks this one through. And they have taken the lead here in the fourth quarter. So the drive here ends with a field goal. It does give them the lead, but this one's still certainly a long ways from over.
It definitely puts a lot of pressure on your defense to hold the lead, right? They're happy to have it and happy to be out there trying to do so. But I know as a former player, in the back of their mind, they're thinking, why don't you score the touchdown and seal this thing?
Is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. Taking it about the 1. A lane opens here. He's past the 30. And all in all, a pretty solid return. Nearly got it to the 35. They'll mark him down officially at the 34. Houston set to take over. And now they find themselves trailing following the field goal. Still a good amount of time in this fourth quarter, but this drive very well could determine the outcome of this ball game. From the 34 now, here's first and 10. Stroud looking to throw. Throw right side, taken in by Collins. And he'll be out of bounds, but able to get it up past the 45. The drive starting with a first down, 11 yards on that pickup.
This defense has certainly had an outstanding second half, haven't they? I know they just gave up a first down there, and for the offense, they're hoping that that's something that they can jumpstart with and maybe start to move the ball a little bit better. But it's been tough sledding for them here the entire second half.
Now here's a throw right side, taken in by his tight end. He'll be taken down at the 48 for a pickup of 2 yards. One thing I think that's safe to say defensively, the tackling's been really good.
And because of that, it's been very, very hard for them to move the ball because you're not getting the benefits of run after catch. They're tackling them almost on the spot. That means they have to run extra plays, harder to move it.
On second down, here's a run with Singletary. And he's going to take this one across midfield and into Colts territory. 4 yards on the pickup there as it'll leave them with a third and about four more for a first.
On any running play that's called, they're always hoping that it's going to break big and go the distance. But when you get a nice game like that, you're able to do so many things anyway. You can come back and run essentially the same play again, continue to move the ball on the ground, or you can decide to throw the ball now because usually you have the defense back on its heels.
And they'll get him to the ground. He has another first down at the Colts' 29-yard line. His first catch, and it's a pretty big one. They get the conversion on third down.
Normally on third down and short yardage, you're thinking to throw to your tight end. It's just going to be a simple chain mover. But this time they let him roam down the field, and a nice dart picks up the first down and then some.
And they'll throw it with Stroud here, first and 10. He'll get this out wide to Singletary. And he'll be out of bounds just inside the 25-yard line.
Just about every quarterback is trained to really look downfield first before you come back and make a nice, safe throw. And in this case, that's exactly what he did. Found his running back, let him create some space, and it turned out to be a nice play for the offense.
And Stroud now to throw. And he'll get this underneath to Singletary. And down inside the 15, shy of the 10.
Another catch for him there on this drive, Brandon. And it looks like they're going to utilize him out of the backfield any way they can. And that time, they pick up a first down. So now on defense, do you assign a man to him and try and cover him before he gets going?
Fourth quarter, 2 minutes on the clock in a tight one-point game. So it's Texans football as we welcome you back. They come up on a first and 10, desperately needing a score here on what could be their final drive. Plenty of time. All three timeouts still remain. Here's first and 10 now. A give up the middle to Singletary. And he'll get this one down to about the 10-yard line.
Well, they certainly had success throwing the ball on this drive and not as much running it as we just saw once again on that last play, stopped after a very short gain. But I wouldn't abandon the run totally because otherwise, pass rushers just tee off on your quarterback. Makes it very, very difficult for him in that situation.
Now Stroud. And it's caught. Touchdown. Brevin Jordan. From 10 yards out, and the Texans have taken a fourth quarter lead. Those are the types of plays in these moments they were hoping for from this young rookie, able to put him up here in the fourth quarter.
How about the kid? You just mentioned it, the fourth quarter. This is when you have to make those winning plays. That's what he just did. Doesn't ensure anything, but he certainly gave his team a heck of a chance, didn't he?
A big spot now for the Texans as they'll try for two. Here's Stroud. And this one's caught. And their fourth quarter lead grows by a couple more. So they're able to throw it in for the two-point conversion. And sometimes that can be a risky play, but they got it.
Yeah, you always have to be careful here, because if you do get it intercepted and it's returned by the defense, that's 2 points for them. But he identified an open target and put it right on him.
So after the touchdown, here's Fairbairn now to kick it away. And here comes a return from just beyond the goal line. And ultimately cannot get this out to the 25-yard line as he's dropped at the 23. So Minshew and the Colts now down by 7, 90 seconds remaining. They need a touchdown and the PAT to tie it as they come up first and 10. Minshew. That's complete to Pierce. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. Obviously a big first down right there.
Yeah, they still got to hustle. They got to get up to the line of scrimmage and get set. But I don't think necessarily you need to spike it, but they've got to continue to move quickly.
Here's first and 10. Minshew. Pass complete to Allie Cox. And he'll work it across midfield inside the 45.
That's exactly what they were looking for. If they get another gain like that, they'll be right there in field goal range.
And the tension building. All three timeouts still at their disposal. Here's first and 10 now. Throw over the middle, going to be caught here by Mo Alie-Cox. The Colts going to use the first of their timeouts as they stop it with 28 seconds to go in this football game. They'll come up first and 10 here. Here's Minshew. Throwing middle, but it's incomplete.
And not a common sight, at least on this drive. A momentary setback, though, for this passing game that has been moving well this series. Good thing for them, though. Still two more downs to connect and try and pick up another first down.
They'll come up now on second down. He's back to throw. And he's going to get this down near the 20-yard line. Now the Colts going to burn the second of their timeouts as they'll stop it with 17 seconds to go in the game. Well, this offense still has the one timeout here, remember. First and 10. They'll look to throw. This is caught, and he is across and in for the score. And now they can tie the game in the final stages with an extra point.
Or they can go for two and go for the win. Obviously, the excitement level here is almost a fever pitch. Down one, is tempted to go for two. I say you go ahead and kick the extra point. You got the home crowd carried into overtime.
I'm with you. I do see some fans, though, holding up two fingers. Easy now.
Yeah, but they're not the ones who have to actually make that call, are they?
Matt Gay on for the extra point. Now the Texans will burn the first of their timeouts. That'll leave them with two remaining. We'll be back after this. Matt Gay on for the extra point. And we may very well be heading to overtime. That time, a six-play drive. And the touchdown and PAT mean we are tied here in the final minute of play. This one, all we could have asked for. All tied, final minute as the kick's away here. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here right at the 30-yard line. This is first and 10. Stroud. Trying to stretch the field with Schultz. Looking middle, and it's incomplete. And we've got free football. Four quarters done, and we're dead even. We'll have overtime after this timeout. So it's the Colts who are going to get a chance to win it here first as we're back underway in overtime. And no return here to begin the overtime session. That'll be a touchback. And now Indianapolis set to take the field. And that last drive, so effective in the passing game, resulting in the touchdown. Maybe not many people were focused on the trenches. There was good protection there.
Excellent protection. So now defensively, you've almost got to get down into those starters blocks like you're a sprinter. Get lower than those guys on offense and find a way to roar through them or around them to get into the face of the passer.
Easier said than done, though.
Way easier said than done. But they've got to try something because right now they're just cutting them to shreds.
And not much to speak of. Call it a one-yard gain up to the 26. Short gain there to start overtime.
Almost a tester play, wasn't it? Wanted to see if the guys on defense were going to fit the gaps the correct way because we're in overtime. So it's not just physical tiredness out there, right? Mentally, are you still doing what you're supposed to do? And they were up to the task on that play.
And certainly fatigue on both sides of the football. Now this will be swung out wide for Taylor. And he'll be out of bounds, but able to get it up past the 45. A gain there of 21 yards.
And that was a beautifully executed screen pass. They let the rushers get upfield and get the escorts in front, meaning the offensive linemen, other blockers out in front, completed the pass beautifully. So now you've got all that open space with big guys leading the way.
Now Minshew, out of his hands quickly to Pittman. And taking it across midfield and just shy of the 40. 11 yards for number 11. Charles, you get into these overtime situations, that's not a bad guy to dial into.
Well, when you have to have plays, especially in a spot as you just described, we're in OT, You've got to go to the guys you can trust and you know are going to make the plays. Well, they say, it's not the X's and the O's, it's the Jimmys and the Joes.
So a first and 10 now in Houston territory at the 42-yard line. And he's going to get this inside the 30. A nice job there on the escape and scramble. A first down, a 16-yard gain.
That's multiple times now he's tagged them with a big gain with his legs. Really showing off some nice awareness and the ability to correctly realize when he's got a chance to tuck it and go himself.
On the handoff, Taylor. And the result here, a pickup of 8. Leaves him with 2 to go on second down. And I know you, with every carry, especially in overtime, you're just saying, if you're that ball carrier, hold on to the football.
Hold on to it, protect it, but not necessarily settling, because you're trying to get to the end zone. You're trying to end the game right here. And I know the defensive guys poking, clawing, raking, trying to knock the ball free and protect their end zone.
Yeah, like you alluded to, especially this part of the field. And that's caught left side by Mo Alie-Cox. And that'll be enough to keep the drive moving forward. Another first down on the pickup of 5 yards.
And the tight end is certainly a position built to move the chains because they can control space underneath. If they've got good hands, then, of course, they're a dynamic target. But one other thing is they're right in the sight lines of a quarterback on just about every play. And that makes it easier for the quarterback to pick him out and deliver.
From the gun, it's Taylor. Yeah, he'll work free from one tackle, but that's about all as he's taken down. Well done to sniff that out defensively. He had it diagnosed pretty quickly.
I love that description because diagnosed is perfect on that one. Read his keys, made the play, and he couldn't even get going moving the football.
Second and 9. Looking to throw it, Minshew. Buying time to his left. And he'll be taken down at the 2-yard line.
There he goes, and for good reason. Running with it has paid dividends earlier in this game and earlier on this drive. And until they prove they can stop him, I don't think he's going to be shy about continuing to run for first downs instead of airing it out.
Minshew sets to throw. And he's got his target. It's caught for a Colts touchdown. There was no going through the progressions on that touchdown pass.
Yeah, nor was it necessary. His receiver won that route early, presented himself. No reason to wait. Go ahead and put it on him and score a touchdown.
Gay is on for the point after. And they will take a 7-point lead now. So a nice drive put together there. They go 75 yards in 9 plays. And the result for the Colts is a touchdown. Sanchez now, he'll kick it away following the touchdown. And he'll be tackled just shy of the 25. Out comes the Houston offense as they get set to take over here. First throw of overtime, Stroud into the hands of Singletary. And he's tackled a yard short of the marker. Good gain of 9 on first down.
And we see another pitch and catch there to the running back. This position just continues to evolve. They've become just as critical to the passing attack as a lot of receivers, tight ends, because their ability to make people miss in the open field can really generate big plays for an offense.
From the 33, here's second down and 1. Stroud to throw it. Now he'll dump it underneath to his running back, complete. And he'll be brought down shy of the 40 at the 38-yard line. A little dinking and dunking that they're doing. At some point, is it appropriate to maybe take a shot?
It is, if you feel good about it. But otherwise, you do what a coach told me a long time ago. Take what they give you, but make them tackle. In other words, get it to one of your guys in space. If he makes someone miss, that could turn into the big play you're looking for.
Stroud. A fight for it, and this is caught. It's caught indeed.
Stay loose. Stay loose.
Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10. Throwing now is Stroud. On the throw, led him too much that time. It's incomplete.
Yeah, their back's up against the wall a little bit, and they come through by forcing an incompletion. Now they've got to continue to ratchet up the intensity a couple of more times and get off the field before giving up any more yardage.
Second and 10. Now Stroud. And on the left sideline, he caught it, but out of bounds, according to the head linesman. Incomplete. So the ball a little late getting there, and it's third down.
Well, what looked like a march to the end zone has hit a momentary roadblock with that incompletion. No need to panic. They just got to come up with a high percentage play call and see if they can get their offense back on track.
Stroud on third down now. And this is caught. I think he got that with one hand. They'll get 10 there, but it leaves him just short for fourth down.
Boy, that completion comes with a high degree of difficulty, especially on the catch. Had to look that one in one-handed, able to do so, and ends up picking up a first down as well.
A big call here in overtime. They're going for it on fourth down. Needing the tough yards, they run it with their fullback. Yeah, boy, that's going to be close. He didn't get much at all there, but he got the first. Looked like they might have held him defensively, but the referee signals it will be a first down. In lieu of the sneak on fourth and inches, they just say, give it to the big man in the backfield.
Yeah, fullback no less. Not many of those left in the NFL, but for those that have one, perfect time to use them, perfect time to get it done.
They'll run on first down with Singletary. And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. No gain on the play. It'll be second down. You don't see that a ton, do you? Or the cornerback coming over to the middle of the field to make a run tackle.
That's someone with a ton of confidence to feel like nothing is pressuring him on his side of the field. Sees that the ball's moved to the middle and just sprints over there to help out. He ends up getting the tackle. Well played.
Here's second and 10. Stroud to throw it. And that went too far in front. He couldn't reel it in. It's incomplete.
His back has been a dependable safety valve all game, so he went back to him when his first read was covered. Just unable to connect, so the play results in no gain.
They had the incomplete pass on second down. Now they need a big play here, third and 10. Stroud. He's going to have the first down and then some. And he's all the way down to the 6-yard line. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal.
And in a lot of ways, that catch is expected. Red zone presence, and that one was realized there. You've got to find your tight end in that situation.
They run here with Singletary, and he's in. Touchdown, Houston. 6 yards on the touchdown run. So, partner, it was a passing game that drove them down the field, but when they get close, they trust that man in the backfield, and he took them home.
And they trust their offensive line as well, because so many of these units, they specialize in either pass protection or run blocking. This group shows its versatility and gets both done on this drive.
On for the PAT, Kaimi Fairbairn. And he's able to put it through. A pretty long drive that time, 11 plays all told. And it was finished off by a Devin Singletary touchdown run. So we're right back where we started, all even as the kick's away. And no effort to bring this one out. It's a touchback. Here comes the Indianapolis offense now as they get set to take over.
So both of these teams, Charles, coming off touchdowns now, but this offense, they just had to stand on the sideline, watch their opponent author a really impressive drive to reach the end zone.
Yeah, and I think you're not telling yourself the truth if you don't think there's some one-upsmanship going on right now, because they just had their touchdown answered by a drive of double-digit plays that also found the end zone. Now they want to do something even more impressive to answer that one.
Minshew, first and 10. He's got his man. It's Pierce. And he'll be out of bounds across the 30-yard line. They'll operate from the 32-yard line here, second and 3. From the gun, Minshew to throw. That complete to Downs.
He kept the receiver in the short field, but that let his quarterback get the ball quickly to him before either guy in double coverage could react.
So from the 36 now, first and 10. Here's Minshew. Finding Pittman. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. Less than 2 minutes to go in this overtime. It's sudden death now, but we are still all tied. They're going to run a little pop pass here. shrugs him off, and he goes across midfield and down into Houston territory.
A nice play design there with the touch pass. Looked good at the start, but bottom line, the defense was ready.
And they did a nice job scouting, didn't they? Not just scouting, but now executing once they saw the play for real after having worked on it all week in practice. They drilled on the play, then they drilled him.
Throwing on second down now, Minshew. He'll find a man over the middle. It's Pittman. And he's going to be taken down with another first down as the stop's made at the Texans' 38-yard line.
But one of the ways the quarterbacks keep all the receivers alive in a play, never lock in on any one guy. Make sure you keep your eyes moving, scan the field, and here he finds the open guy for a nice pickup.
They give to Taylor out of the gun, and he'll take this ahead for about four. Second down coming up. Now a timeout called for by the offense. They'll be down to just one remaining as we step aside here in overtime.
Line of scrimmage, the 24. This is second and six. Again, it's Taylor.
Not a ton of room available on that one, but he made use of what space was available and gained decent yardage.
This will be play number eight here on the drive. It's third and a yard. Now here's a fake on the jet sweep, and instead a give to Taylor. And he is going to have a Colts first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
We use the word relentless a lot with guys who are aggressive on the field. In this case, it really fits, doesn't it? How about his ability to break tackles and his feet never stop moving?
Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. It'll be their second and final timeout, remember, here in overtime. We'll be back. So it all rests now on the right foot of the kicker, Matt Gay. And now the Texans want to call another timeout. They'll be left with just one remaining here at OT. And now it all rests on the right foot of their kicker. This to win it in overtime. And he got it. The kick is good. And they have won it here in double overtime.
A lot more was on the line in this one than just defending your home field, CD. They defend their home field against a division rival and get the victory, so this one feels a little extra special.
It has to, right? There's always just a little more emphasis on games like this. Everyone talks about playing each game the exact same way, but you and I both know that is not true. Division rivals, you want to take care of business not just at home, but against a team that you really don't like very much, too.
That'll do it for us. For Charles Davis and all our hardworking crew, I'm Brandon Gauden. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. For more, find us on Twitter at EA Madden NFL. The Colts are winners as we say so long from Indianapolis.